Dramatic program created by Rio Grande.
Los Angeles Police calling all cars, attention all cars, broadcast 179. Regarding a holdup on 3rd Street between Spring and Broadway. This man is there now, so hurry over. Rosenquist.
Gasoline, like good food, adds to the pleasure of living. If you are used to the best of either, the commonplace is not acceptable. That's why the best authorities on gasoline, those to whom gasoline means most, overwhelmingly recommend Rio Grande Crack. That's why more police cars, fire engines, ambulances, and other emergency equipment are powered with Rio Grande Crack gasoline wherever it is sold than any other brand. That's why for month after month, Los Angeles, Oakland, Berkeley, Marysville, Fresno, Santa Barbara, Pasadena, Monterey Park, Glendora, Linwood, San Diego, Phoenix, Las Vegas, Orange County, San Diego County, Maricopa County, Coconina County, and many, many other cities and counties specify Rio Grande Cracked gasoline for all their emergency equipment. Let this fact, then, be your guide to finer motor performance. The fact that last year your law enforcement agencies drove over 50 million miles, the equivalent of more than 2,000 times around the world, powered with Rio Grande Cracked gasoline. This is the most conclusive, authoritative proof of gasoline superiority ever made in the West. This superiority is due to the internationally famous Sinclair cracking process, which in the West, only Rio Grande can use. Tomorrow is the time to get police car performance in your car. See your independent Rio Grande dealer. You'll get more power, greater pickup, better mileage, with Rio Grande Cracked gasoline. As is our custom on this program, we have the privilege to present Chief James E. Davis of the Los Angeles Police Department. Chief Davis.
Good evening, friends. The life of a peace officer is, to say the least, varied in the extreme. There may be days, even weeks, in which no act of violence occurs which calls for anything more than mere routine investigation. Sometimes periods come in which activity is at fever heat. In some cases, the solution of the crimes is swift and sure. But in many cases, much work has to be done before the criminal is brought to justice. But eventually, every crook will be caught and justice administered to him. Such a period of feverish activity was the week of March 11th to March 17th. It was literally murder week in Los Angeles. 8 homicides were reported in that week. 6 of the cases were marked solved on the day of the occurrence. The other 2 were cleared the day after they happened. Thus is the efficient work of the Los Angeles Police Department ever ready to protect the citizens of this locality. But the show is ready. I'll have another word for you at the end of the program.
On the night of March 11th, John Morrison Snelling was standing at 3rd Street and Broadway selling papers to passers-by.
Read all about it. Paper, morning paper, all about it. Paper, sir.
And what edition is this?
Oh, this is the last one this evening, mister. Next one's the morning edition. You get it home.
All right, I'll take it. Here you are.
Thanks, mister.
Well, wonder what's going on down there. Sounds like somebody throwing bottles.
It comes from that liquor store, too. Maybe it is bottles. Yep. There were one out in the street. Let's get down there.
Wait a minute. Here comes the man out of the store. Hey, that's a holdup. Get a cop.
Hey, stop it. That's a holdup. Stop it.
I'll get him.
Oh, help somebody. This dude boy's a stab. Help police. Somebody help.
What's going on here? Come on. Stand back, everybody.
Oh, I'm doing, officer. My wife and I have just bought a paper.
You saw him do what?
I saw the man come out of the liquor store and start to run. The newsboy tried to stop him, and the man stabbed him.
All right. Stand back now. Let's have a look. Right over here, doctor.
Oh, what's the trouble? Huh? Pretty bad. Won't do much good, but we better get him to the hospital. All right, man, let's go. Steady. Oh, there you are. See you later, Hill.
Anybody see which way the killer went?
Well, he ran down Spring Street toward 4th Street.
He crossed 4th. I saw a man running and noticed he had a gun in his hand.
He tried to hold me up in my service. When I wouldn't give him 20 bucks, he was going to take it himself. And that's when I started throwing bottles
at him. We'll get your statement later. Come on, Ed, let's take a run down Spring and see what we can find.
Checking, 6th and Spring.
Anything doing?
Just had a stabbing at 3rd and Broadway. Killer running your way. Watch for him.
Okay.
Hey, lady, you can't make a U-turn there.
Officer, quick. I just saw a man running down the street and he said he had a gun in his hand.
Well, let's drive back up there.
Well, stand there on the running board. There was a lot of excitement on 3rd Street when I came by.
Yes, I know about that. Take it slow now. You see the man?
No. No, I don't. Yes, there he is. He's hiding in that doorway there under that hotel sign. You see him?
I see him, all right. Hey, you. Hey, what are you doing here? Want to play pig, huh? Okay, pal. Boy, when I catch you, here, you mug, what do you think? Cut me, will you?
I'll show you. Hey, stop. Stop or I'll shoot. You asked for it.
Well, that settles that.
The evening of March 13th, officers Hollivus and Stanger speed to 956 East 23rd Street. The call is man lying on porch of house.
Well, this looks like the place.
956 is the address. Yeah, there he is, right in front of the door.
Looks like he's still alive. How are you feeling, fella?
Not so good, boy.
Who shot you?
Only mine, boy. Let's get to a doctor. They'll fix me up. I'll tell you all about it later.
We haven't got time to call an ambulance. Let's get him in the car. We'll ride him down ourselves.
Okay, boys, come on in. You can talk to him. Costello, here's an officer who wants some information.
Okay. I'll talk now, Bob.
Well, what happened?
Well, Bud and Rudy and me was arguing about splitting the Columbus stuff. And
Paul Barnes ain't no good. He's too hot to try to unload in Los Angeles. You ain't going to count him in, see? We're going to split that Columbus stuff four ways.
Oh, no, we ain't. We're going to split it just three ways. Me and Albert here and Rudy. You didn't do nothing on that Columbus job, and you know that. And, big boy, you ain't going to get none of it.
Yeah, that's what you say.
And you heard me say it.
Yeah. Well, see if he can hear this.
You hadn't ought to have done that, Bud. Well, that... You man like that, I ain't never done you no good. I crawled over to the telephone after the others beat it, and then I called the cops. Reckon I must have passed out there on the porch, though.
Well, what did you do with the St. Paul bombs?
Find Buddy and Rudy and Albert and... we'll find them.
Passed out again. Well, I've got a hunch we'll find those birds at 956 East 23rd Street. Let's go.
The hunch was right. Less than 30 minutes after Costello talked to the officers, the men he had implicated were in custody.
Los Angeles police calling car 124, car 124, 8510 South Broadway, investigative shooting. That's all. Rosenquist.
Where you been? We've been looking everywhere for you.
Oh, I've been down to Georgia Street Hospital.
Hospital? What's wrong?
Well, you're sick, Gloria. No, I just didn't remember who I was or where I was. Well, what happened to you? Well, they told me I'd been wandering around town, and an officer picked me up and brought me into hospital. It's awfully nice, though. Where's John?
Your beloved husband's out looking for you. You better be in bed when he comes back.
I think I will go to bed.
Well, when did you get back?
Well, just a few minutes ago. I was sick.
Oh, yeah? Well, you're not as sick as you're going to be. Get in your room.
You can't talk to her like
that. Can, huh? Listen, punk, you take another crack at me and I'll poke your face in. Go on, get in there like I said. I'll smack your teeth
out. You ever hit my sister again, I'll kill you.
Oh, yeah?
Now, Charlie, don't meddle in your sister's affairs. She's old enough to take care of herself.
Well, that guy's nothing but a broken-down prize fighter. He never will amount to anything. He's always beating up sisters. Well, if he doesn't stop it, I'm going to take a poke at him.
Well, he's bigger than you, Charlie. If I were you, I'd keep out of it. What was that?
Sounds like he's beating up sis again. I'm going in there.
Now, don't butt in, Charlie.
You little tramp, I'll teach you.
No,
come back in here.
Charlie, where are you going?
I'm going to stop this.
Oh, put that rifle down, Charlie. Charlie, do you hear me?
Take your hands off my sister. I told you to keep out of here. What are you going to do with that gun?
I told you what I'd do if you ever touched her again.
Oh, no, you won't.
Get out from in front of him, Gloria.
I can't. He's holding me. Oh, Joey, don't shoot. Don't shoot.
Turn her loose, Hennessy. Okay, punk!
Lieutenant Let Veteran Hirsch found John Hennessy dead. Within a few minutes, Charles Luntz had told his story. He told it again and again, first to juvenile authorities and then in court. Obviously, it was a case of self-defense and the defense of his sister. Consequently, today, he's a free man.
Buffin is police calling car 12, car 12, 11th District, 627 East 5th Street. See the manager.
You the manager?
Yes.
Who are you?
Joe Filkes, police department. This is Officer Baker.
Ah, yes.
You called?
Yes.
There's a dead man in room 33.
How do you know he's dead?
How do you know you're alive?
It's funny, huh?
No, but I know a dead man when I see one.
Yeah, let's have a look.
Down the hall. First door after the turn.
Yeah, right, come on.
Meet Brawl.
Brawl is right.
How many men live here?
Two.
Well, where are they?
A guy named Jesse Blair and that one, Joe Javitich.
Dead or not, Darnell?
How long ago did you find him?
About 10 minutes.
Only been dead half an hour.
Is no hour shot?
No. Looks like a blow on the jaw.
Yeah, that wouldn't kill him.
You wouldn't say that if you knew Blair.
How do you know Blair killed him?
I don't. I only know that this evening about 10 o'clock I passed by here and I heard Blair say that...
Just went.
man we passed back there on the road.
It does at that. Let's turn around and get another look at that bird.
Right. There he is, right there on the bridge.
We'll stop and ask him a few questions.
Okay.
Hey, you. Come over here.
Look, he jumped over the railing.
Come on, we'll soon catch that baby. Hey, wait a minute, you.
What is it you want with me?
Where's your gun?
I have no gun.
Well, what did you kill that woman with?
With a knife. I cut her heart out with knife just as she had cut mine with her laughter.
And at 2:35 on the afternoon of March 18th, the day after his crime, Francisco Cancino was in custody. Another crime of murder week.
Los Angeles police calling car 11, car 11. 110 North Main Street, 110 North Main. See the man. That's all. Rosenquist.
That's the joint?
Yeah, 110 North Main.
I'll go in and see what it's all about. You phone for an officer?
Yeah. There's a man just left here and said he killed a woman.
Where?
Up on Commercial Street in a hotel.
You know this man?
Yeah, he's an old guy. Always talking about when he was a jockey.
What's his name?
He calls himself Wells.
I'll go over there and have a look. Well, sounds like murder.
A call came in while you were gone. Some dame's been stabbed over on Commercial Street.
What? Say, that's the story I just got from Christmas on the waiter back there.
Yeah, better take a run over there.
Quite a crowd around here.
Yeah, it looks like the ambulance beat us to it.
Hi, Doc.
How does it look? Looks bad. You'll probably die. No one did it?
Well, I have a pretty good idea. Where's the manager of this place?
Hey.
You're the manager?
Yep.
Got a bird registered here named Wells?
Yes, right up there. First door to the right.
Thanks.
Who's there?
Friend of yours, Wells.
I got no friend. Go.
Come on, come on. Open up.
Who are you?
I want to ask you some questions, Wells.
Oh, go away, cop. I've got to wash my hands.
Go ahead. Don't mind me. Why all the washing?
Got blood on him.
How'd you do that?
What's anybody here?
I'd like to take a ride, Wells.
On your horse?
Oh, no, not exactly. Thought you might like a nice auto ride.
Hate him.
You'll like this one.
Got any women?
Well, we might find one for you.
Okay. Where are we going?
To the General Hospital.
What for?
To see if Doris Sylvia can identify you as the man who stabbed her.
Right in here, Lieutenant Patton, please.
Right on in, Wells. How is she, Doc?
Pretty low.
She's conscious?
Yes, but she's suffering pretty badly.
Able to make an identification?
Well, I think so. We'll try, anyway. Mrs. Sylvia? Mrs. Sylvia? She's coming around a little. Mrs. Sylvia?
Yes?
Mrs. Sylvia, we want you to help us.
Yes.
Is this the man who stabbed you?
Yes. That's the man. That's John Wells.
Is gone.
Yeah, it's coming to her.
How long Doris Sylvia remained in that hotel room before she was found and taken to the hospital, no one knows. Fortunately, she was able to identify her assailant before she died. Another victim of murder week.
Los Angeles police calling car 66, car 66, 6550. 6748 Franklin Place. A dead body reported in a garage at that address. Maybe a murder. That's all. Rosenquist.
Look, Whaley. You go back and take a look around the garage, and I'll go in the front door and talk to the landlady.
Okay. See you back there.
What did you find, Whaley?
Nice mess.
I'll say you did.
Looks like somebody smashed his head with a brick. Oh, you know Johnson and Simpson, don't you?
Sure. How are you, boys?
Okay. Just got the call on this a few minutes before you fellas came up. Been looking the place over.
Whoever did this did a complete job. Beat him over the head with a brick and then cinched his necktie around his neck. From the looks of the car here, the fight must have started inside.
Yeah, take a look at that bumper and headlight. Blood everywhere.
Probably ran into him, too.
Say, Johnson, did you find out the landlady's name?
Yeah, I got it here in my book somewhere. Mrs. Biscara.
I think we'll have a talk with her.
money. You know where he works?
No, senor. But some of the boys say he, how you say, killed the guy.
Tin-horn gambler, eh? You know anybody who didn't like him?
No, senor. Oh, but wait. It was yesterday. I think I hear a boy who lives in room below say he did not like the way Felix plays. Maybe he...
Where is he?
He has work now, but he come in very soon. You wait for him, no?
Yes, in his room.
Oh, I did not expect...
Must have here so soon, eh? Come on in, Max. Don't stand there with the door open.
What is it you want?
Do you want to know why you killed Felix Pignon?
Me, senor? I do not kill anybody.
Now, listen, Max. I'm not going to stand here all day arguing with you. You want to make a statement here or at headquarters?
I have no statement to make. I do not kill anybody.
Mrs. Vizcarra says that she saw you leaving the garage at midnight last night, and you told her nothing had happened.
It was not midnight. It was...
Yes, yes, go on.
I was not there at midnight.
But you were there earlier, weren't you? What time did you see Pignon last night?
About 8 o'clock.
Where?
Downtown.
What were you doing?
We're playing cards.
Who won?
Felix and the other two. The names, Ramirez and Pablo.
Ramirez and Pablo what?
I did not know of the names.
Don't lie to me, Max.
I know. Lie, I didn't know of the names.
Then you lost your money gambling and started a fight.
No, I do not. Started Felix here.
So that's it. Pignon attacked you, eh? That right?
Yes, that is it. He hit me, sir.
You started a fight downtown, did you?
No, we fight in car. We...
Oh, so you did fight in the car,
no,
eh?
No,
it's... Well, your own story.
We do not fight at all.
Okay. Was the car in the garage then, or did you drive it in later?
It was in the garage.
And the brick? Was it in the car or in the garage?
It was in the... I do not know. There was no brick.
Okay, Max. Now, look. We know you quarreled with Pignon. We know you were short of money. We find bloody trousers in your room and a bloody shirt. Your fingerprints are on the car. Now, we can wait until you're ready to talk, or you can talk now. But you might as well know now I'm going to take you down to headquarters and book you for the murder of Felix Pignon.
No. I did not murder him. He would have killed me.
Now, then you did do it.
Yes. I will tell you everything. Felix cheated me. He robbed me. Many times he beat me. So I killed him.
And to officers of the police department, Vergara told his story. Another crime of murder week.
Los Angeles police calling car 112, car 112. 5625 North Figueroa, 5625 North Figueroa, a hold up in progress. That's all. Rosenquist.
Give me a bottle of scotch.
Prince Bob.
And the cash
what?
Out of that drawer.
Say, what is
this? Stick up, buddy. Move fast.
You can't do this to me.
And, hey, say, listen, you pop-eyed lump. Get back at that counter and get that quick. Al, get that money out of the drawer.
Okay. Yeah, well, coming off here,
ah, scram bum.
Hey, you can't call me a bum. I'm a respectable citizen. I don't have to stand for talking.
Smack him with a bottle, Al.
Oh, tough guy, huh? Okay, pal. You want to wrestle?
Yeah, I'll wrestle
you. Hey, nice going. Miss me. Strike one. Hey, don't be throwing my liquor around.
Pipe down. Here, you mug. I'll help you, Al.
Look out, don't. Look out, you old man. Get a gun.
Why, you old... Scram. Scram, Al.
I don't know. He walked in trying to stick the place up. That man over there started a fight, and I shot this one.
Where'd the other guy go?
He jumped in the car and beat us.
We'll never get a line on him in this weather. Find anything over there, Lopez?
This guy keeps saying we'll find the other bird's fingerprints in this broken glass. It'll
take years to find it.
He's trying to smack me with his bottle. He's trying to get his fingerprints on the glass. He picked it all up with fingerprints on it.
Well, it's a gamble. Might try it.
Boys downtown will murder if you bring all that glass in there.
He was going to hit me.
I know. He was going to hit you with a bottle. Well, so am I if you don't shut up.
I just thought maybe you'd find your fingerprints.
Say,
on...
did you hear me?
Sure, I heard you, but you better not get your fingerprints all over this.
Come on, let's take this junk down to the office.
Number 22, no print. 23, no print. Number 24, no print. Say, you sure the guy did pick up a bottle?
That's what the customer said, and you know about customers.
Well, maybe this customer was wrong. Number 29, no print. Number 30, no print. Number 31. 31, wait a minute. Here's something, Jeff. There's definitely something here.
You know whose it is?
Well, that, in all my years of experience, is the most original remark I've heard. Yeah, take it around the server, the latent print, and find out for yourself. They won't need this stuff anymore. Sure smells of gin. Hello, Brian. Find anything in the dead bandit that was bumped off up in his cell?
No, every mark's been taken off his clothes. Oh, I found this pamphlet in his coat pocket.
The Gospel according to St. John.
I wonder where he got that.
He's out at the Union Mission on Main Street, apparently.
Hey, look, fine. Here's a verse underlined.
What does it say?
Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friend.
The slain bandit was later identified as George Rudd. Thus, murder week in Los Angeles comes to a close. Again, it is demonstrated that crime does not pay. 8 out of 10 automobiles are using the wrong grade of oil. How about yours? Or do you know? If your oil is wrong, you are, unfortunately, wasting many dollars every year, and it's so easy to remedy. The Law of Lubrication is written by Sinclair, refiners of the world's finest motor oil. Your Rio Grande dealer can tell you by the Sinclair Law of Lubrication the exact grade for your make of car at its present mileage. You must know this to lubricate your car intelligently. You'll save money on gasoline, oil, repair bills, and add to the life of your car. There are hundreds of oil companies, but 1 out of every 10 gallons of oil used in the United States is refined by Sinclair. More than 150 railroads, 8 transcontinental airlines, great fleets of ships use Sinclair motor oils exclusively. Motorists of 45 nations depend upon the internationally famous Sinclair motor oils to lubricate and protect their motors. Tomorrow is the time for you to start saving money and saving your car. See your Rio Grande dealer tomorrow. Sinclairize for safety with Sinclair motor oils and get police car performance with Rio Grande cracked gasoline. And now again, we hear Chief James E. Davis.
I wish to express my thanks and the thanks of the people I represent, you, our listeners, to the officers who participated in the arrest which we have heard tonight. The splendid work of peace officers and the cooperation of citizens will make our communities dangerous for lawbreakers. Thank you and good night.
Police calling all cars. Attention all cars. The cancellation broadcast 179. Suspect now in custody. That's all. Rosenquist.
Narrator, Frederick Lindsley, bidding you good night for Rio Grande.